Maybe some of you are sitting there thinking, I still don't feel like I've got a gift. I still don't feel like God has given me a gift. Well, I'm sure you'll all have heard of the saying, practice makes perfect. And while perfection itself may never be reached, practice certainly leads to improvement. A few years ago, I learned to drive. And in order to learn, it took hours and hours of practice. The 10th time I got behind a wheel, I was infinitely better than the first. And I think the same can be said of how we use our gifts from God. The more we practice, the more we try, the better we can get at it. Imagine a worship leader. A worship leader doesn't rock up to church one Sunday morning, stand up, pick up a guitar, and suddenly know how to lead everyone in an awesome time of worship. No. Behind good worship leaders are years and years of practice, years of keeping trying, years maybe even of asking themselves the question, am I good enough? Can I really do this? The more we practice, the better we get. Maybe the gift itself we're good at. Maybe it's practicing how and when to use that gift. Take, for example, Joseph. Joseph was given the gift of dreams. Joseph shared some of those dreams with his brothers. He interpreted what they meant. His interpretations made his brothers angry. They got cross, so cross that they sold him into slavery in Egypt. And yet later down the line, we see Joseph's dreams being fulfilled. Joseph was great at discerning his dreams from the start. What Joseph wasn't quite so good at was discerning how to share those dreams with others, how to explain what they meant, who to share them with, when it might be appropriate to do so. But as Joseph practices more and more, one of the key dreams we see him interpret is Pharaoh's dream of the years of favour and the years of famine to come over Egypt. Pharaoh being so pleased with Joseph that ultimately he put him in charge of the land. So maybe you're sitting there thinking that you don't feel like you've got a gift. But can I encourage you not to give up now? Think about those hobbies, think about the skills that you have. Maybe even the things that at the moment you cannot see how they have anything to do with your relationship with God. Remember what Darren shared about Esther. How could anyone think that beauty would have helped Esther in her relationship with God? And yet she used it for his glory. So don't give up. Keep seeking God. Take every opportunity he throws at you. Use your hobbies, use your skills, and see what God does through you. And you know what? You might mess up along the way. Maybe even you have messed up. Maybe you're currently facing the question, what do I do now I've messed up? Or what do I do if I mess up? We'll check back in tomorrow to hear a local youth pastor, Ellie, share on just that.